Determine if the following series is convergent or divergent. We have the sum from n equals 1 to infinity of the difference of 3 to the power of 1 divided by n and 3 to the power of 1 divided by the quantity n plus 1. This is a telescoping series. A telescoping series is a series in which most of the terms simplify out or cancel in each of the partial sums, leaving only some of the first terms and some of the last terms. So what we'll do is determine a formula for the partial sum for the infinite series, and then take the limit as n approaches infinity of the partial sum. If this limit exists, then the infinite series converges. We'll also know what it converges to. If the limit doesn't exist, the series diverges. To work on determining a formula for the partial sum in terms of n, we will rewrite the infinite series, changing the variable to I, and then let n be the upper limit of the index. So for the partial sums, we have the sum from I equals 1 to n of the same formula for a sub n, now just a sub I. And now we'll start to generate the terms in the series. First, we have I equals 1, which gives us 3 to the first minus 3 to the power of 1 half. And then we have plus when I equals 2, we have 3 to the power of 1 half minus 3 to the power of 1 third. Plus, when I is 3, we have 3 to the power of 1 third minus 3 to the power of 1 fourth, and so on. Notice the last value for I in the partial sum is n. When I equals n, we have 3 to the power of 1 divided by n minus 3 to the power of 1 divided by the quantity n minus 1. And now let's analyze the terms in the series. Notice a lot of the terms are opposites. Starting on the left, notice we have minus 3 to the power of 1 half and then plus 3 to the power of 1 half. So the second term in this first set of parentheses simplifies out with the first term in the next set of parentheses, and the pattern continues. Next, we have minus 3 to the power of 1 third plus 3 to the power of 1 third. So again, the second term in this set of parentheses simplifies out with the first term in the next set of parentheses, and so on. Notice that negative 3 to the power of 1 fourth would simplify out with the first term in the next set of parentheses not shown. And then for the last set of parentheses, only the 3 to the power of 1 divided by n would simplify out with the term in the previous set of parentheses. This last term does not simplify out. So now we have a formula for the partial sum S sub n. S sub n equals 3 minus 3 to the power of 1 divided by the quantity n plus 1. And now we need to determine the limit of S sub n. So the given infinite series equals the limit as n approaches infinity of S sub n. And now we determine the limit. Notice as n approaches infinity, the exponent of 1 divided by the quantity n plus 1 approaches 0 because the numerator is 1 and the denominator increases without bound. And therefore the limit is equal to 3 minus 3 to the power of 0 or 3 minus 1, which equals 2. Because the limit exists and is equal to 2, we know the given telescoping series converges. And we also know the infinite series converges to 2. I hope you found this helpful.